All right, well, good morning, everybody. I'm gonna try a game that I hadn't played in an extremely long time called Total War. This is the Three Kingdoms version. It's a game it's a version that's based on my all-time favorite book, Romance of the Three Kingdoms. The moment I saw this, I knew immediately I had to get it. I remember playing Shogun Total War, like, back in the 2000s, 2010, somewhere around there. So, this is a title that I'm somewhat familiar with. But also, like usual, I'm in the middle of setting up right now. So, and I did see that there's an introductory movie on this. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to see if I can get it going. Give people an idea of what the story is and stuff. But like I said, I'm still in the middle of setting up, so. Come on, Wi-Fi. There we go. Okay. One more thing I gotta get. I'll go grab that now, and I'll be right back. Not much of a stream without cinnamon rolls. Okay, so let me get this over here. Again, I want to see if I can use a controller with this. Yep. And welcome aboard, Kataro. Like I said at the start of the stream, I played Shogun Total War, like the very, very, very first one, back in like the 2000s or like 2010s when it first came out. So this is a title I'm somewhat familiar with. Let me get that wire out of the way. Okay, let me. And I'm doing this for the very first time, so I don't know how well it's gonna play. Like if it sucks up a lot of my resources, if it lags big time, I'm probably gonna have to kill it and go on to something else. But one thing I wanna do first. There was a video that played right at the start of this. Back up. I don't want to do that right now. Alright, I guess I'll start with the new campaign. Okay, I'll just start with the simple stuff. Now, in the book, he's actually painted as a bad guy. This guy here is painted as a good guy. This guy here, he's somewhere in the middle. These two here are the lesser warlords. He's based in the Northeast. He basically rules the entire northern part of China, but on the downside, he sucks as a ruler. So eventually he loses his kingdom to this guy. You want Shu? Pretty much as it says here, ambitious power monger. He's pretty evil, doesn't last very long. But as a Liu Bei kind of guy myself, I'll start with him.
Be watchful for fate's gifts.
Liu Bei sees chaos in the face of Dong Zhuo, and will not rest until the tyrant's corruption is uprooted and the Han Dynasty restored.
Yeah, this guy here, Dong Zhuo, he's basically pure evil. He'll slaughter innocent people without giving it a second thought. Torture him, he'll mutilate him. He'll kick the current emperor off the throne just because he doesn't like him and install his, like, maybe he put his nephew in his place just for the hell of it. I'll go ahead and start.
Embers rise, stark against the night. The tyrant Dong Zhuo wields the flames of destruction. Luo Yang burns, chaos ignites, as the power of the eunuchs is crushed. In the pyre, the Han falters. Yet the light of the dynasty still simmers in the hearts of its last descendants. Liu Bei swore an oath with his brothers. They pledged their lives. They will defend the Han. Nobody else can. China is in turmoil. The great empire of the Han, stretching back ages beyond counting, is being devoured by corruption. The Yellow Turbans, thousands strong, began raising their banners in rebellion and seizing commanderies across the realm. In response, generals loyal to the Emperor rose up and put down the rebellion. Yet, despite the victory, the chaos only grew. With the corruption at the very heart of the Empire, the loyal generals stormed the Imperial Palace and killed the 10 eunuchs, the source of China's...
Pretty cheap, I imagine.
In the madness, the warlord Dong Zhuo seized the Emperor. With the great warrior Liu Bu at his side, none dared oppose him. In response to Dong Zhuo's brazen display,
there's actually some pretty decent voice acting from what little I've heard of it so far.
Warlords rose up, led by
usually in a game like Dynasty Warriors, the voice acting sucks.
Faced with united opposition, Dong Zhuo retreated west to his stronghold of Chang'an, razing the old capital Luoyang to the ground as he fled.
Yep, he also went in all the graveyards and looted the corpses.
It is now the year 190 CE, and the coalition has all but collapsed. Warlords on all sides have seen opportunities to build their own fortunes from the chaos. Yellow turban remnants still stalk the lands, seeking the age of the yellow sky, whilst soldiers of fortune feel the change of fate on the wind and strike out on their own. The scales shift, and China hangs in the balance.
Okay, I'm on the task manager right now. Holy balls! This game's taking up almost all my GPU. Yeah.
Luo Yang lies in ruin, my lord.
You know, this is a game based in China. Why does she have a British accent?
What's of the people?
Dong Zhuo has fled west to Chang'an, with the young Emperor Xian his captive.
He holds my nephew at sword.
The coalition delays and wastes time. You are poised, ready to strike now.
But Yellow Turbans and bandits still persist. There must be justice. The people deserve peace.
Your sworn brothers are ready to fight. Their oaths were bound long ago. Dong Zhuo's treason must face justice. We are arrows on the wind, my lord. We fly wherever you command.
Seized him. He basically kicks him out of power and puts his own nephew in his place. Okay, and then believe it or not, back when I played Shogun Total War, I actually didn't even do any of the fighting at all. Most of my time was spent just in the simulation part of it. Now, unless they made this very, very easy to do, I might end up skipping it if possible.
This is one of your armies, used to attack enemy armies, conquer settlements, and defend your own territories. Guide them well, and China will be yours.
The absence of people is indicative of China's sickness.
You know, again, this game is based in China. They shouldn't have a girl with a... They shouldn't be using a British voice actress doing it. I mean, what next? Texas?
Little boy won't stand in my way. Hee-haw! Come on, everybody. Let's raffle stomp him.
I cannot.
Okay, so...
Under one banner. With heaven!
We have engaged the enemy in battle. Now it is up to you to command your forces and destroy our foes.
Okay, quick save here. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and start battle, but just to see what it's like. Again, if it's just gonna totally use up all my resources, and I'm pretty sure my stream's probably gonna be lagging like crazy because of it, And looks like as it is now, I'm already gonna have to deal with loads and loads of loading. If all this becomes an issue, I'm just gonna do auto battle.
Under callous warlords and brutal tyrants. I weep for China. But only we can provide the salve that the people sorely need. We must restore the Han Dynasty to its rightful place if we are ever to know unity, stability, and peace.
Yeah, CPU is at the max. CPU is almost at the max. I'm not gonna do anything. Not gonna do anything special, just gonna go ahead and start.
A duel is single combat between two generals. Troops will honor the duel and not interfere unless ordered otherwise.
You are weak!
Your words are as pathetic as you are.
A comrade is being attacked!
With rage.
The enemy warriors are running. Ha!
Okay. You're gonna be a lot harder than that. Okay, I think battle here, from here on out, I'll probably just go ahead and auto resolve it. Loads and loads of loading. Jeez.
Victory is yours, and the fate of those you have captured in battle must be decided. You may bolster your ranks with the remaining enemy soldiers, or kill them to prevent them returning to fight you again.
Okay, I'll ransom and release them.
I am not a cruel man. Marching! Fortune favors the vigilant. Destiny awaits.
No matter how devoted your soldiers are, rest is needed between marches. Try to manage your army's movements so they can rest in safe locations.
That'd have been nice to know before I actually moved my army, honey. Okay. All right, let's go attack them. What am I missing?
For justice.
Okay, let's go attack them.
Secure loyalty through respect and action.
Okay, so what else am I supposed to do then?
Your faction not only consists of settlements and armies, but your policies, reforms, and family affairs. All contribute to your rule and deserve consideration.
With honor!
No two battles are the same. Remain flexible and
We must
the enemy's defenses have fallen. And now those that cower inside await judgment. You may occupy or sack the settlement, among other options. Each will leave it in a different state, with its own consequences and advantages.
And if you can look at, the effects here, occupy, loading and occupying, it makes a huge difference. Cause if you look at here, 20% of the population is gonna leave if all you do is occupy. But if you're gonna loot them, a lot of the people that live in here are thinking you're a total jerk off for doing this. So more of them are gonna leave. So you only want to do this when you absolutely need the money. Secondly, it's always better to capture a city intact than it is to do any of these other two. So, especially if you're anticipating a counterattack, you don't want to destroy the city at all. So,
it would be prudent to occupy this place.
Your armies are composed of generals and their retinues. A retinue is made up of up to 6 units, and once a general is recruited, these loyal followers will follow them into battle, in service of your cause.
I assume I'm going through with it.
Think on this.
Except, he's a good guy.
Our talks flow as smoothly as the river.
There are many intricacies to ruling, and a wise leader seeks counsel rather than allow pride to lead them into ignorance. If any aspect of your kingdom eludes you, you have only to ask for clarification. As you gain prestige throughout China, you will be rewarded with a rank befitting your power. Your options and resources will increase in line with your authority.
So I'm guessing he leveled up. Range, block chance. He's not a vanguard. Liu Bei is not known as, Liu Bei is not a, is more of a ruler than a fighter, so. Yeah, so he's. Okay, I'm clicking it.
Virtue begets justice.
Strike true. A battle is upon you. Consider the size and types of units in each army, as well as who the attacker and the defender is, in order to develop a winning strategy.
That's where I'm going.
Strike hard.
Starve them out.
As I walk this land of homes and families, I see China's future.
True ambition is not to match the great deeds of the past, but to build upon them. Reforms create fresh practices. Military tactics, philosophies, laws, and tools.
There was an option in here to move, to change my UI around. Excuse me. Wish I knew where it was. I'd like to move that window over. Triple population growth. See what this one was. But I'm starving them out again. Bloodshed should always be a last resort, not a first option.
The type of terrain your army crosses will affect the speed of their move.
Summer is soft, humble, but warms all.
If a battle looks like it will fall in your favor, you may pass on command to one of your subordinates, so you can concentrate on more pressing matters.
Nope. Keep starving them out. Just gonna delegate it.
I grant you this boon.
A warlord must be skilled in politics if their faction is to thrive. Maintain stability amongst your generals and court nobles by keeping them satisfied or banishing dissenters that threaten.
Good lord. Man, I didn't recall things being this complicated.
boundary consists of a capital and... Check that your army is well stocked with supplies before they embark on a long march or enter enemy territory. If they run out, your troops will start.
Jeez. Man, I don't recall things being this damn complicated. Yeah.
Buildings improve various aspects of your faction, making development of your settlements vital. You can construct one building at a time in each commandery. So if nothing is being built, you are missing an opportunity for development.
You know. Okay, so how do I upgrade? Supplies are running low, so...
For justice.
Your armies take different stances for different purposes.
Don't care about that right now.
The mountains do not apologize for their ambition. Why should we?
Okay, this whole thing is just way too freaking clunky. You know, I kinda want to move the camera up to where he is. Okay, problem solved. Okay, now I want to order him to back off and head into town. We're heading into the nearest settlement because my supplies are almost nil.
With all your might. Justice has shown us the way.
Same thing here. Gotta occupy them.
As they fight side by side, your general's bonds will deepen as...
Yep, I remember this. Ever destroy the... Yep. She's gonna drive a wedge between these two. Basically saying the same thing to two different people. He's hurting me. So.
Remain resolute.
The number of buildings you can construct in a settlement is dependent on its size. Expand your commandery capitals to make room for additional buildings.
Okay, this is not a very user-friendly game. So the way things are looking right now, I'm probably just going to go ahead and break off of this game and pick up another. I don't know yet. But yeah, it looks like I'm going to have to abort this because it... Right now I'm spending most of my time being confused. I mean, camera's clunky, can't really do the battles, to say nothing of the fact that this game is about as bad as Monster Hunter World. It's taking up almost all my resources. So... So yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and quit. Temporarily, I'm gonna go ahead and kill the stream. And then while I go dig up something else to play. So... Sorry, everybody.